Good morning guys, so today I'm going to tell you how to import your Spring project or any of your web application project into your Eclipse. This is the scenario when you get some projects or when you bring some project from other programmers or from your friends, and now you want to import them to your Eclipse IDE. So talking about today's concept, first go to the location where you have stored your project folder. Like this is one of my project, Saffron Airlines, and the whole project folder is here. As you can see, we have the POM file, we have the SRC, and when we go in the SRC, we'll get all our code like Java code, web app resources, and many more. So you just need to open your Eclipse IDE, and when you click on the file, you'll get open projects from your file system. So now you click on the open and you'll get this dialog box, and here you need to do is you need to select your project folder by clicking on the directory section here, and then you go to the specified location. Like I have put my folder in my computer, and then the drive is actually G, yeah, and there the folder name or the project name is Saffron Airlines. So this is the main folder. You just click on the main project folder and click on OK, and the next step you need to do is just finish the operation. And as you can see here, that the Saffron Airlines has been imported. So you might also see that there are some error symbols or sign, and this is nothing. Actually, I'll tell you what this is. So see the error symbols in the SRC has been removed. Sometimes it occurs itself and sometimes it goes itself. It is not in our hand. Still we can configure it what the problem we are getting. So like as you can see, we are getting an error in hibernate config.xml, and what you need to do is sometimes it works and sometimes it may not work. Just remove and do control J, see, and the error actually this works. Okay, so I have another solution for this, and what we're gonna do this time is actually we will go, we'll click right click on the folder, I mean project folder, go to the properties and go to the deployment assembly, and then click on add. Okay, Java build path entries next, and if you see here Maven dependencies, that means your Maven dependencies are not added, and you are required to, it is required to add your Maven dependencies. But as we are not getting any Maven dependencies, we have already added our Maven dependencies. Actually though, this Maven dependencies actually contains your jar files which are required for your Spring and Hibernate configuration. Those jars which are actually defined in your pom.xml file. So go to the Java build path, and I think everything seems well here. You need nothing to do here, and go to the project facets, and just click apply. Okay. So this is what I mean to say. You just don't worry about these error symbols, because it will go when you update your Maven. And right click on the folder, Maven update project, and don't forget to check this force update, and then click on OK. After updating your Maven project, you need to run your server, I mean your project, and then you will get your, I mean you'll get your project running, and proper counseling. The Maven project has been updated and the workspace is being built. Okay, so now we are all set to run our project and right click. As you can see, the server has not started yet. The server will now get started. Yeah, the server is started now. The server is not starting because we are getting some error, and all you need to do is go to the program files and go to the folder where the Apache server has been installed. Go to the bin and go to the shutdown and then run it, and after that again we have to run our project. So now, as we can see that our program has run, and we can see our home page. This is our home page, and this is our login page. And this is our register page, and we can now run our program. One thing I would like to say is that we just go to the hibernate config.xml. You have to go to the resources, and there is the application and properties file, and you just need to change your database name here. Here, our database, I mean our database name is Saffron Airways. You can change it from what airways or anything name of your database according to your own database name. So this is how you need to run your program, I mean your project. This is how I told you. And if you guys have any problem regarding your any assignments or regarding your any question about your project, you just mail me. So this is my official Gmail ID, javadesk@gmail.com. So thank you guys, if you have any questions or any confusion, you just comment down in the comment section and let me know what problem you have. And if you have any problem, you can also mail me here. I'll definitely reward you.